Houston, what up world? It's your girl Wit here, the dopest black historian, bringing you the dopest black history. It's June, and you know what that means? It's dope Houston history. We're getting into that all June, all month. For Houston's Dope History Month, we're going to be talking about everything that pertains to Houston and the black community. From the first churches established in the area, highlighting places that black people used to go to in the times of segregation. I'm even going to get into what's going on today in the city. Houston's history, music, and black culture is unmatched, bar none, baby. Dopest History would love to get into the dopest black history in regard to my favorite city, Houston, Texas. So, let's get into it, y'all. I know we're all here for the dopest black history, but I'm a historian at the end of the day, so we gotta rewind and get into, you know, the white history. You know, them crazies over there history. You know, the history that they've told us, but really when you uncover, we recognize it's our history, you know? So I'm gonna get into it. I'm gonna give you some background, you know, some background info on the founding of Houston, Texas. It goes into a little of the Texas history, because if you did not know, the name of Houston actually comes from Sam Houston. I won't give him all his accolades, the little general, the colonel, whatever. We just gonna call him Sam Houston. He may get called some other names and things of that sort because he's a phony fake and everything else. But we're gonna get into that when I get into that. I just had to give y'all, you know, a little pre, like, you know, this is what we're about to get into. I know that y'all are expecting black history off top. Let's get into it. Yes. But we got to get into the background. I'm a historian. So, hey, I love history in general. What's the history to Houston? What's the history to the background name of Houston? How was Houston founded? Let's get into it. I will be reading from my notes because, baby, I'm not, you know, I knew the white people history to, you know, get A's and things of that sort, but this doesn't really interest me because it's lies. You know, I'm not really interested in lies. I'm all about the truth. I'm a truth teller. Okay? Yay to all my truth tellers. But anyways, let's get back into it. White people. Although Houston is named after Sam Houston, and many would like to remember him as a hero, Dopest History is here to shed some light on that, okay? I gotta shed the light on the real. Let's get real, real with it. Stay here, okay? Sam Houston, to give a little background on him, he was crazy to say the least, okay? Accused in 1832 by a congressman of fraud, this man went into white privilege mode, okay? Y'all know what white privilege mode, remember January 6th? Y'all remember that? White privilege mode, okay? He beat the living brakes out of a man 2 weeks later at the Capitol. Sounds familiar, huh? Acting crazy at the Capitol. Any repercussions? Anything happens to him? I wonder. What do you think was the con? What do you think happened? His lawyer was Francis Scott Key, who wrote the Star Spangled Banner. That's a little history tidbit for you. Mr. Francis Scott Key was the lawyer to to Sam Houston, and then he was also friends with Andrew Jackson, who was the president at the time. So Sam Houston really was like good, just like, you know, the people in the insurrection in January 6th, they didn't really get in any trouble because they knew the people. Yeah, that part. Yes. White people in him doing his white privilege. Him displaying his white privilege. That's just what it was. That's ain't nothing new. This is way back in the 1800s, baby. 1832. Y'all know I love to get into the dates of things. Show you how much time ain't really shit. How much stop thinking that they're going to change. They're not. 1832, pulled out the white privilege mode at the Capitol. 2021, did they not pull out the white privilege mode at the Capitol? But okay, let's keep going. Okay, let's go back. Okay. At 35 years old, he married a 19-year-old through an arranged marriage. His marriage fell apart less than 6 months in, and he would resign as a governor in 1829. In Virginia, to later become the governor in Houston in 1859. So let's just put this in perspective, okay? Sam Houston is celebrated as Houston's hero because of his involvement with defeating Santa Anna. If you need the background to the Santa Anna thing, we can get into some Texas history. You know what I'm saying? This is dope Houston history. But let me know. Y'all want some dope Texas history? because we could do that too. Because I am going to actually do some dope Texas history with dope Houston history. Because not only am I Houston, I'm a Texan. So, yeah. And my ancestors was really doing shit in the state that, like, literally wrote and made it clear that they didn't want us doing a goddamn thing. Okay? That's the crazy part. Sam Houston was a coward. Okay? You hear me? Sam Houston was a coward. And the only way the Texans at the time were able to gain independence was by doing a sneak attack on Santa Ana. Was not playing fair, playing very dirty, but we know that's how their game goes. Okay? They was getting their ass beat point blank, period. Santa Ana was whipping their ass every time they met on the battlefield. Couldn't get a dub for nothing. Couldn't get a win for nothing. So we had to come sneak up on them. Sneak up on them. While he was asleep, I think it may have been like a truce time, maybe even, or something. Look into it for the specifics, but no, it was some bullshit. Cheating. Not fair, because it's some rules to the battlefield, and he wasn't really as general and high mighty as they would make it to be, because if he was, he would have been able to lay the attack and get it done, but Santa Ana said no, so he had to get him in his sleep. That ain't... Anyways, to me, Sam Houston's story as a whole is very sad. But you know, here we are in the city of Houston. Houston, H-Town. I don't hold the traits of Mr. Sam Houston, but I am very proud to be a native here. But all right, y'all, that's enough white people in history for today. I will be, you know, doubling back, giving y'all some more background history as we get into things. If you have any questions, please let me know. I am trying to bring you guys the dopest black history, but I'm a historian, so I'm willing to bring you any history that you're wanting to know, specifically to, you know, to anything that I'm talking about. So I hope you guys are having a great week. We're going to have a even better month. It is Dopest with the Dopest Historian, bringing you the dopest black history. Make sure you follow, subscribe, and all of the social media things. Peace out.